Hello, I am Guna. I am a professional social worker. I have experience in counseling. 15 years ago, I picked up a girl who was brought to me. I foster cared for her for 8 months. She was infected with HIV and she went into AIDS stage and died. Those days, there was not much medicines to save her. That was a great loss for me. Before her death, she said, "You made my life so happy and joyful. There are so many girls like me on the street. Mama, why don't you bring them too along with me?" That desire was there for me to help these children who are on the street, left behind by parents who die of AIDS. My burden to start a home for these children grew a lot. I shared my burden with my husband. We prayed for a few months together, and my husband joined hands with me to set up a home. He brought a lot of things like bunker beds and utensils and bed sheets and pillows and furniture, and he set up an office for me. All was set, and then after a week he has to leave for a mission trip and he died in an accident. That brought a lot of commotion and loss, shock to me and my son and daughter. My son was 17 years old and my daughter was 12 years old, and I didn't know what to do with a home that was started a week ago. Of course, my well-wishers, friends and relatives told me not to go on with Grace Home. As I was praying and grieving, one day there was a knock at the door in the afternoon. A old lady, a poor old lady, brought up a 3.5-year-old girl into my house and said, "She is positive. And I heard about your home, can you take this child?" I knew what God wanted me to do. On that day, I began Grace Home. By 2008, I had 13 girls with me, fully orphaned and semi-orphaned. My focus with these kids was to help them to know the Lord and His love. Every day we would have devotion in the morning and in the evening and discuss with them about Bible stories, take them to Sunday school and church so that they know the Lord and walk with the Lord forever. Secondly, I wanted them to be well educated because, a girl without education can be easily exploited in Indian society. So she needs to be economically free and socially liberated. So education is a must. I want the girls to learn the value of sharing. Otherwise, it would become difficult for them to share the love of God. They must learn from the beginning to share their belongings. So I used to take them to Ragpickers Colony and see how the children are so underprivileged, living in a very dirty atmosphere. And I would take them to the hospitals to visit the children who are suffering with sickness. I would take them to old age home and handicapped home. They had a beautiful interaction with them. By this experience, I wanted my children to learn to be thankful to God, learn to be grateful. They should be motivated to share their life with others and help the others in the society. 9 years have gone by and it's so fun to watch them grow. As children, I had to give a lot of time and my energy to help them out. But now you see them as young women who are cooking, washing, cleaning, and they are very self-dependent and self-reliant now. Now they have a family and the basic needs are met like food and shelter, but they are growing and now they'll be going to university. So the biggest need is education for them. College education is going to really uplift them economically and socially. They all have been motivated to study further so they can stand on their own feet, earn for themselves. Living in a children's home definitely comes with a stigma, and people know their parents died of HIV and AIDS and they are very sensitive about it. But when they go into the university, they are going into a bigger circle, and with God's strength and faith in God would move them forward to break all the stigmas and discrimination in their life. They get an opportunity, privilege to share the gospel and make a difference. I want all the girls to realize their own potentials and talents so that they will be able to go and serve the Lord with whatever potentials and talents God has given them. My dream for my children are that they grow as a family with a sense of belonging, because they all come from a different family, and I don't want them to feel they have no family when they grow up and stand as a woman. But I want to give them the sense that they are one family. Grace Home is a family. Though they come from different families, they are sisters in Christ, and they grow helping each other, and they know they will surely depend on each other in the future.